Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the previous lecture, we introduced quadratic functions. We saw that a quadratic function of x is any function which can be defined by the expression ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b, and c are constants which determine the shape and position of the function's graph. We also saw that although the constants b and c can be zero, in order to be a quadratic function, the constant a must not be zero. A quadratic expression can be created by multiplying two linear expressions together. As an example, let's multiply two linear expressions, 3x plus 4 and 2x plus 1. We can expand the product of the two binomials using the distributed property. To do this, we must multiply each term in the first binomial times each term in the second binomial and add the resulting products. These products can be created in any order, as long as the individual products are formed by multiplying each term in the first binomial times each term in the second binomial. The order of multiplication we will choose is called the FOIL method. FOIL is an acronym which stands for multiplying the first terms of the two binomials then the outer terms then the inner terms and finally, the last terms. Once we have produced these four products, we can combine the two x terms, giving us the quadratic expression 6x squared plus 11x plus 4. So using the FOIL method, this product of binomials was produced by multiplying the first terms, the outer terms, the inner terms, and the last terms of the two binomials. Since the quadratic expression 6x squared plus 11x plus 4 is the product of the two linear expressions, 3x plus 4 and 2x plus 1. 3x plus 4 and 2x plus 1 are factors of that quadratic expression. In later lectures, we will learn several methods of factoring quadratics, including factoring special products, factoring by inspection, and factoring by completing the square. In addition, we will see how any quadratic function can be factored into two linear functions through the use of the quadratic formula. But before we study methods of factoring, in the next lecture, we will examine two different ways to write quadratic functions and see how those forms are related to the function's graph.